From the sea foam, Aphrodite rose, full grown, beautiful as that same pearl.
I can't take this anymore. Zeus, Gaia lied to you about how Aphrodite was born.
Oh yeah? Then tell me how it really happened.
And Kronos, they fought.
You can't be serious.
Fell into the sea.
That's...
because Kronos cut off his...
You're sick, Prometheus! Do not talk to me!
With the sea foam secure... Phoenix resolved to return to Aphrodite with the key to her freedom and the vault.
You've returned, you sweet creature. Do you have the seafoam?
Right here.
Oh, aren't you good? Please, take my blessing for all your hard work. Now quick, pour the foam on my roots. The sooner I can move, the sooner I can expand my apple care.
Did it work?
Coming out of the foam, I was so fabulous. No, there's too many cuddly creatures that need my help. It keeps me awake at night, just seeing their little beaks and bright eyes. And those noses, those quivering wet noses.
What just happened?
Typhon must not like you, though I couldn't possibly imagine why. Whenever anyone defies him, he sends one of his wraiths, and that wraith delegates responsibility, as wraiths tend to do, to Shades.
So the warrior that just appeared wasn't really Achilles?
Goodness, no! The true Achilles is far more dashing.
Oh, you're telling me.
He's hiding in a lair nearby. Until he's defeated, his shades will reappear on this part of the island.
Is there ever any good news?
Well, the sea foam worked and I'm able to move my roots. One of them was actually blocking Achilles' lair. I can't help but the other three wraiths, though, Heracles, Atalanta, and Odysseus. Oh, you know what they say? Bad things come in fours.
No one says that.
No one says that.
Tough crowd.
What about the root blocking your essence? It's just that some people I care about have been turned into stone, so I'm quite keen to...
Nope. For some reason, that root is still firmly in place. Thank you for your concern. But what matters is I can start delivering apples. All the animals will be fed in no time. Let's get to it. Thank you kindly for all your help. Many happy returns.
But I... That was strange.
I can't keep standing idly by.
Sorry, I mean busily preparing anymore. You have to bring Aphrodite back to her beautiful, snarky self before I go crazy.
By the gods, where did you come from?
Behind you? Doesn't matter. Don't worry about me. Focus on finding another way to shrivel that root.
So what? Saltier, more mythical water? Actually, wait. What about Aphrodite's tears? Didn't she cry at the death of Adonis? They'd be salty and powerful.
You really know your stories, kid. Her tears just might work. If you put them directly on the root, blocking off her essence. Now, where did Typhon hide them? You should search the vaults of Tartarus nearby. There are three crystallized tears.
All right, we have a plan then.
Please hurry. Until Aphrodite is back to herself, who will I talk to about whatever this is that you're wearing?
What's wrong with what I'm wearing? And he's gone.
Huh?
Antonia! Ah! The smelliest of festivals, totally appropriate for Adonis. He didn't belong with Aphrodite, she was better than him.
Adonia was a celebration of women's self-expression. They would dance on the rooftops, bringing scented plants like fennel and cabbage to their parties. In the spirit of Adonia, isn't it Aphrodite's choice who she loves?
Not when it's rotten, like that smell.
And yet, the women of these villages let it waft from the rooftops, year after year. Maybe the freedom to make the choice is what matters. Phoenix would have to participate in the festival to open up to Adonia if the vault itself was to open.
That little turn of phrase and you light up like a pomegranate tree. Oh, I see you, Prometheus.
You have your pleasures, and I have mine.
Deep within the vault, Phoenix found one of the tears Aphrodite shed over Adonis.
I really don't think Adonis was worth all this crying. It was just a pretty face.
Thank you.
Phoenix left the vault victorious, tear in hand.
Smelling only faintly of cabbage.